Greetings, I, the War Owl, greets you, and I'm going to be showing you here, once again, another 5 vs 5 Counter-Strike Global Offensive match, and this one's going to be from the Grand Finals of Dreamhack Winter 2013. This is it. You guys wanted to see a cast of this game, so here it is now. Fnatic versus the Ninjas in Pyjamas, and right off the bat, we got shooting going down middle, and Vronax takes out Forest. That is a very quick start to this thing, and now we have Gidright looking up short as terrorists are trying to take any position anywhere, but JW pushes through, takes him down to counter terrorists here at short. Gidright trying to jump up, trying to take those players down and actually forcing those CTs back. Two of them do jump down into CT spawn, just in case you're trying to do a mid to B. But it looks like Terras are committing to an A push now. They've lost two players. It looks bleak for them at this point, and they're going to have to get really lucky. But we have a smoke off there of short. They're not able to push here because of that, and it looks like they are still going to be trying to do this, waiting for that smoke to clear. There are, of course, two players inside of CT spawn, expecting them to go middle. Flusha going to be inside of A, waiting for them to go short, and they are going to be going short, so it's all up to Flusha here. He can stop this right now. And Terra's pushing into the site using the rest of their flashes, trying to get position. Counter terrorists have already rotated back here. We'll be taking these players down. Now just going to be Faflaren left, and we'll be going down as Flusha pulls out the knife and goes for that kill. So, wow, we have a complete roll there. First round, Fnatic doesn't lose a single player. Ninjas in Pyjamas now very far behind. Will they do a P250 armor buy? And that will be a yes. And they will be doing this new P250 armor buy strategy here on the terrorist side. And we have Fnatic going to be buying just in case they do that. So they will have strong weapons here. 3 M4s and 2 Famases. We have armor and helmet on everybody, except for Pronax. And it looks like Terrace will be pushing through at long A, taking two players out right away. Devilwalk is going to be trying to hold this off from Carr, but Terrace are now pushing forward, have grabbed the M4s there. Looking good. Counter Terrace have rotated. Both of them are inside of CT spawn. This is going to be a difficult cross for the Terrace, but they do take them down. Exist grabs the last frag and puts this thing 1-1. That was a P250 armor buy steal there. That's exactly why you use that strategy, because on that second round, you're forcing those players to buy up. And of course, armor P250, good enough. All right, Fnatic now will be doing the same thing. Another armor P250 counter buy here, going against what looks like a full buying Ninjas in Pyjamas. They do have one Galil though. And we do have, this is crazy, man. We got P250 armor buys. Whole game, Pronax here with a 5-7 to try and hold this off. Exist in position to take him down. And get right there, trying to take on two players with a pistol long range. Schneider moves in, but he does go down. Terrace doing a good job here holding it off. And two players left on the counter Terrace side. Looks like that P250 armor buy may have been a little bit of a waste of money. Bomb is now going short to go plant at bomb site A. Both of the counter Terrace are inside of B. All Ninjas in Pyjamas has to do is hold them off. They need one player at mid to watch them rotate. And we have Freiburg here. And short, here's the player at mid. Gonna be Gidright. Sprays down Devilwalk through that smoke. Pronax, the last player left, has the armor and helmet, so it is worth it to save. However, it looks like he is trying to grab a few exit frags here. Try not to make this a complete roll. He's given away his position. Terrace can now move in for the kill, and it is going to be Gidright to get that. So, Ninjas in Pyjamas now, 2 points to Fnatic. A P250 armor buy against the full buying players, of course, did not work there. So now Fnatic should be full saving at this point. Don't want to put themselves too far behind. Can't just do P250 armor buy every single round. And Ninjas in Pyjamas now has a huge advantage, so it will be a save round. They're watching middle to see who crosses. They see that just one player crossed, so they can easily just move in there and take B. And we have all of the counter terrorists now pushing at short. This is a very common save strategy on dust2. Ninjas in Pyjamas completely aware of what they're doing and sets up exactly for that strategy. So it's a very common save strategy. And they only cross one player, so it was kind of a giveaway that they had all their players at A. You move all your saving players here, or you boost up, and push them all here at short. Then, when the players either try to move short or come from lower B, they can catch them off guard, especially when they try to jump up on the Xbox. However, Ninjas in Pyjamas completely aware of this, move players lower B to watch this, and players mid as well, to try and get good position and watch them at short, and it definitely worked. They even were pre-nading them. Good round from Ninjas in Pyjamas. Alright, Now Fnatic will be able to buy on this round. They're doing a 2-1-2. Two players in B, one player mid, that's going to be Flusha. And two players playing A. One at long, one at short. It will be a mid to be there, so it's going to all be up to Pronax, who goes down. Flusha goes down as well. Now going to be Devilwalk and JW to try to do the retake. Terrorists already have position inside of the site. It's going to be an easy hold off for them. And it looks like Counter-Terrorists will be saving, but will they go for the exit frags? Here's Devilwalk watching middle. And we have JW hiding over here. Terrorists are fanning out across the map, looking for these players. Exist, may get caught off guard here. JW hears him coming. And will catch him off guard, take him down, and then change positions. Ooh, Faflaren is there now. 24 health, could be grabbing that player. His buddy Devilwalk goes down to Freiburg, and get right, grabs the last frag. Fnatic is not able to save any of those guns. Another great round from Ninjas in Pyjamas, starting this thing off strong. And this is, of course, dust2. It is a little bit of kind of just sort of terrorist-sided. However, teams generally like to choose CT side first on this map, even though there's a slight terrorist side advantage, and the smoke advantage goes to terrorists at the start. They can sort of decide how the game goes. They can look down middle, they can split off to get good intel on that. It seems like a round where Ninjas in Pyjamas would have a little bit of a disadvantage, just because Ninjas in Pyjamas' strength is on very CT-sided maps. And this, of course, is the exact opposite of that. We actually have Counter-Terrorists here with the pistols trying to push at different positions, but it's not going to happen. Here is Gidright. 18 health left, so he can actually get picked here by Pronax. Pronax has a huge chance. Oh, but Gidright overkill, takes him down, shoots him in the face. He is going to be Flusha, last player left with the silenced USP. And just trying to catch these players off guard and grab a frag. He doesn't have to live this round. No reason to save. He has no reason to live. And he will pre-shoot at the Forest, but Forest takes him down. Ninjas in Pyjamas now leads 5-1. The only round that Fnatic won was that pistol round. Oh, but they're going to be buying this time. They have an auto shotty. Well, this is a good, auto sniper here, and then two ops. Flusha and JW both will be opping, and then they also have an auto sniper. So three scoped weapons against Ninjas in Pyjamas, zero. Let's see where they put this auto. And they will be watching mid with it. They also have an opper at long. They should have the other opper at B. Oh, the other opper will be playing middle, and they rotated that auto sniper into B. So they have a scoped weapon at each of the sites. This is a very strong defensive play here by Fnatic. And here is Flusha to go for these picks at long, where it looks like Ninjas in Pyjamas is trying to pick. They've left one player, probably get right over at short. And they will be pushing at long. This is a very common strategy that Ninjas in Pyjamas pulls. Allow get right to get those rotate frags. Get right's now at middle. Pronax not able to stop him. And they might try to push a player up the elevator here. Devilwalk. No, they will be playing the cross. Waiting for these players to push. Pronax pushes forward and trades himself. Terras have not yet been able to cross yet. They have all the players there. JW pushes through that smoke and grabs the player down with that op. Grabs another one, and then Devilwalk from down there in elevator takes out Get Right. Great holds off there by Fnatic. Three players lived that thing. They still saved that auto sniper in one of those ops. That was a really nice CT side hold off there. It's an expensive one though, and it paid off. All right, Ninjas in Pyjamas will be opping this time. It is on Forest here. Dust2 is a map where Faflaren is the player who plays op. So interesting that we have Forest here. Does pick off Schneider and goes after the other player playing mid. That is going to be JW now with this op. Has a good pick right at the start. That's going to give them a huge advantage here. Defensive smoke by Pronax, preventing them from pushing B. Look like Terrace did try to go B, but now they have to sort of try and take mid control and wait for those defensive smokes to clear. But taking that one pick, of course, Freiburg is dead. Taking that one pick is going to give them a good advantage here. It's hard to hold the thing off when you have lost a player like that. Okay, Counter-Terrorists playing two players at short, two players B. Exposed areas are long A. Of course, these players here at short can watch the cross. Nice shot by Devilwalk. Terrorists now getting ready to push at short. And we have a defensive smoke and a flash. Terrorists should not try to push through there, but they are! Terrorists pushing at short A. Wow, goodness. And now we have Flusha to hold it off. He does go down. Nice job. And going to be a 2-versus-2 now. Now just Pronax. 1-versus-2. Terrorists will take position inside of the site and will get that bomb down. But Get Right is low. He's going to be up to Pronax He's given his position away, trying to pre-shoot that player, who is not in that position. We see Git right there. Forest at long. They hear this player pushing out. They can pop out at any time, and they will get a good crossfire on him, and Forest will take him down. That's a four frag for Forest. Let's get an owl vision. Lovely work there by Forrest. And he takes the point there for his team. It was a nice attempt there by Pronax, but when you're doing that 2v1, it's always best to try to set up a crossfire so that you engage 2-on-1. You don't try to take him out one at a time. That way you can have one player engage. He'll go after that one player. Oh, look at that. Nade stack and spray down at B. They take both of those players, and we'll be taking that site. Oh, these, of course, saving players is not too terribly, terribly good. But here is Aflusha. 1v5. Probably not going to happen. See, when you do that 2v1, one player's going to pop out and say, hello, try to get that pick, and then fall back. That player will engage the first player who picked him, and then the other player can pop out of the other spot and take him down. Always try to engage 2 against 1. Take advantage of your advantage. Sun Tzu was wrong. Sun Tzu said, if your forces outnumber the enemy 2-1, divide your forces. That's not the thing to do in that situation. Sorry, Sun Tzu. Alright. We do have 3 counter-terrorists push at long, and then 2 should rotate back. This is a common CT sign set up here by Fnatic. 2 players rotate back, leaving JW with the AWP to play long A. Anfi Flaren here is going to be player long A. Terrorists do take mid control. They can go anywhere now. The counter terrorists have been sort of doing the buddy system here. They've been putting 2 players together usually. It looks like they want to push short. So here's Devil Walk to hold this off. Looks like Fnatic has had to buy Famuses. They have 3 Famuses. They're definitely going to be money hurting at this point. Probably will have to save if they lose this thing. In this round, they could have saved this round instead. Going to be going for it here. Do have enough money to buy these Famuses. And terrorists are getting ready to push at short. Oh, we have Freiburg there jumping through. This is pretty much the nip strategy. And Freiburg does grab the frag and trade himself. Allows terrorists to push at short. And they will be taking bombsite A. But here's Flusha with the Famas holding it off. But Flaren doesn't land the shot. It will be get right. And he is missing, trying to get the little headshots. And will be pulling back. Bomb is down inside of A. 30 seconds left and get right. Oh, he's still engaging here. Still trying to get these frags. Put himself in a difficult position at 20 health against 1v2. Probably not going to happen. But it is get right. He pulls out the clutch. Oh, did have a shot there on Flusha. Flusha, he could kill Flusha at any time, but Flusha turns and kills him because he gave his position away there with that flash. Wow. If Get Right turned around, he would have seen Flusha's head sort of going by slowly. Goodness. That was close. And then he could have put it at a 1v1 and had a chance at winning that thing. All right, Ninjas in Pyjamas ahead now, 7-3, but Fnatic is starting to win rounds as CT. There's still money hurt, though. We actually have a Mag 7 buy here from JW. He's going to push forward here. His buddy's going to help him get good position. Then he's going to charge forward, set himself up at a close position to try to grab those one-hit kills as those players move in and make this gun actually worth it. But there's Fflaren. Ooh, he sneaks by. Fflaren's got to hold off this Mag 7 player. JW will not push here. It will be up to Fflaren if he pushes in here to check his corners. And terrorists will be pushing at short. They've dropped that bomb, though, to go B, so they are going to fake at short A, and then we'll be going B. Here's Freiburg. Usually throws a smoke down into CT spawn, then jumps down there to take out the players playing mid. And it looks like he's thinking about doing it. There's the smoke. This is not the smoke for that, though. Actually, watch where these smokes go. Oh, they are going to be smoking it, so I think Freeburg's getting ready to do his parkour stuff. And here he goes. We'll be jumping into CT spawn. There's the parkour stuff. Gets him from behind. I love when he does that every time and exists here by himself, holding off the rest of the team and going for rotators as terrorists push into bomb site B. We'll be planting that bomb, but here comes Flusha. doesn't hit Forest there, and will be trying to retake this thing. Devil Walk and Fluxia. It is looking bleak here for Fnatic on this round, and they are going to be pulling back and saving those weapons, grabbing two AK-47s on their way out and saving that thing. Nice job by Ninjas in Pyjamas. That's pretty much the Ninjas in Pyjamas strategy there. So they had that bomb dropped over here at B, so you knew that they were going to be going B. They sort of had mid control there. They allowed Freiburg to go here and short A. They throw one smoke out here and one smoke out here to prevent vision of the players in A seeing him. Then he jumps down, picks the player here, and then they do a B take. B take and a split B. This is a nice strategy. You take out that player middle, put yourselves in a good position to take B after you take that player down. It's just two players here inside of B that you have to take, and you can take them from two positions. Love it, and it works. It all relies on Freiburg. All right, and get right being a little aggressive here, trying to peek those players, now pulling back. There's no defensive smoke. He's trying to bait out the smoke. Smoke is not down just yet. Counter terrorists don't have a lot of money. They, of course, did save. They only have two AK-47s between them. Both the players, Devilwonk and Fluxia, did buy armor. This is a smart CT side thing. They have very good use of the money. They saved their weapons and their armor. Oh, but Devilwonk does go down. Now just going to be Fluxia left. JW picks up the gun, though. And Fluxia grabs the frag. Here's JW at short. This looks like a round where Ninjas in Pyjamas should win, but now it's a 3-versus-3. It is even. Get right, make some noise. This is going to keep Fluxia back. And Terrace will be trying to take bombsite A at this point. So Fluxia now rotating back here. Get right is at middle. Ooh, trying to time that player. Very good timing. Just like 2 seconds off there. And not able to hit Get Right. Get Right is holding this down. Does take him down. Now a 2-versus-2 retake on a save round. Good position Fnatic put themselves in. But they don't have a lot of time left. All right, they're setting the crossfire again. No, they're just going to be leaving the site. That bomb actually isn't. Is it planted for long? I don't know. You actually could smoke and defuse that thing there. Both the players playing long. Two counter terrorists walking up there for us, trying to time it. And. Oh! They can't defuse that bomb at this point. And there goes Freebirds holding off 1-versus-1. Fluxia trying to exit here. He's got 3 frags, but... Oh, he kills him before he goes down. He did lose that round, but let's get an owl vision on Fluxia. A magnificent loss if I ever saw one. Saved that round. Only had 2 players with guns because they saved those weapons instead of engaging. And were able to frag every single ninja. Wowzers. That was a nice save round. Alright, Fluxia playing aggressive at short. Trying to prevent these terrorists from taking short control. That's a well-timed nade, and it actually will hit exist. Terrorists. Moving forward, Fluxia being forced back. Alright, so they have 2 players inside of B once again holding this off. They're playing it in aggressive positions. Get Right might try to peek here. If he peeks, he's in trouble. This is good. They got 1 player on top of the other. From Get Right's point of view, it's going to look pretty scary in there. Will be smoking it off. Did see Pronax in there. Oh, but Schneider moves in from the other side and takes him down. JW hold off Flaren and does see him. Pulls back a little bit. And here's Fluxia now. Inside of the site, but Freiburg takes him down. Now looks like Terrace will be pushing forward in to take A site. This is their big chance. There is no player inside of the site. They don't even really check it to make sure, and they will be getting this bomb down. It'll have to be a retake here, but here comes Fiflaren, who's been left behind. All right, now, good shot by Freiburg. He is just owning this round. Devilwonk goes down. And we have Fiflaren still sneaking up behind this player who is at long A. That is going to be JW, who's now trying to hold off these terrorists. We'll be falling back. And Oh, he's really holding out down the fort there. Trades himself with the forest. That's the best he could hope for in that situation. And Ninjas in Pyjamas will take another point, putting it 10-3 here. Fnatic is in some serious trouble. This is, of course, a best-of-three series here. So even if Fnatic loses, they have a chance to come back. All right. Another save round from Fnatic. They're going to save and try to go for the last point. And we do have some spraying down the middle. They did see those players. They know that they're saving. They can play against a save round. Oh, what? Exist just took some shots from those USPs. Really nice pistoling there. Now at 25 health, trying to exit there. And Ninjas in Pyjamas playing it pretty passively, allowing Fnatic to make their move. Try to pick those players off. Looks like they're getting ready to take that bomb. JW runs forward, and Exist gets caught reloading with his pants down. And there goes JW. He goes down. And Schneider, the lone player, will be taking on Gitterite. Oh, almost had it there. Wow. And Fnatic will lose that pistol round. All right, here we go. Last round. They save so that they were able to buy here. They got JW with the AWP. Looks like he's setting up to play this thing at long A. And I think they're going to do just a regular setup again. Push a few players long, then pull back. Have two players inside of B. And we have two players crossing. What is Schneider doing? Looked like he was like, I think I can go CT, but nope, not going to happen. Pronax goes CT, though. Wow, they really wanted to put a player lower. And they do have a player lower now. That's going to be Pronax down to 16 health, though. Oh, they could pre-nade him. And he does go down. Two counter-terrorists have been picked. That's very bad for them. They played this very aggressively, and that is going to be to their disadvantage. We've had a duel here at long between Fifflaren and JW every single round of this game. Let's see what happens. Oh, dear. And that could be a comeback here. We actually have JW now as positioned behind them. Schneider to hold off the front. And JW falling back to watch at long A in position to off these players. We're now flashing and smoking off Schneider. And JW, they heard him. They saw him cross. They know he's there. And Fafleren takes, or Fraber takes him out. And that's going to be that. Ninjas in Pyjamas ends this half. 12 points to 3. They are definitely going to be ahead. And they're going to be switching over to the other side. Ninjas in Pyjamas sort of setting themselves up here for the win. And Fnatic, if they want to stay in this thing, needs to win this pistol round. And we shall return after the half. There's your halftime scorecard. The second half is commencing. Fnatic will now be taking the terrorist side. Ninjas in Pyjamas on CT. And I think this is where Ninjas in Pyjamas, it's going to be a little bit difficult for them, because they aren't able to control this map. And we do have Fnatic now. They really have to win this pistol round. They won the first pistol round and then lost it on the P250 armor bond. This is so important, and they will be pushing short. Ninjas in Pyjamas leaves this position open, and they'll be able to just waltz in here, leaving Pronax behind to kill Rotators or die himself. Wow, all of the Ninjas in Pyjamas. That strategy was pretty much to converge on mid, but Fnatic sees the weak point, pushes at short, definitely was studying this team, and knew that that was how this thing was going to be going there. We have all three of the Ninjas in Pyjamas at short A trying to retake this site, but a very good hold off here by the terrorists. Now just exists left 1 versus 3 on this pistol round, and he has to go for it here. Oh, and Flusha takes him down, and don't worry, guys, Fnatic still in this game by taking that pistol round, and we shall see, probably more than likely, another P250 armor buy from the Ninjas in Pyjamas here. And there it is. Love that. Even if they lose the P250 armor buy, they should be able to buy fourth round. So there's no reason not to do that strategy. On CT side. And the 5-7 here by Gitrite. Many players prefer this 5-7 over the P250. We have, looks like Terrace will be pushing here at long. And P90 spray downs. P90 second round, by goodness gracious me. Didn't work out though, so I maintain P250 second round by. Not a good idea. And Terrace Playing long A, then pulling back. Ninjas in pyjamas not calling their bluff, or calling their bluff, pretty much. They only have Fuflair in here watching long with a B2000. And they've now pushed middle for mid control, but this is going to be perfect for the ninjas in pyjamas. They have Get Right at short, and they have Forest inside of B tunnels. Oh, Devil Walk, not aware of this player, does get surprised! And Forest will be grabbing that Galil. Now has a weapon. Players will be pushing here at short A, trying to take the site. This has been the weak point for ninjas in pyjamas on the first round. And they have Get Right already in position. Both those players do go down, so now Ninjas in Pyjamas has to try to do this retake, sending Forrest at long A, and Freiburg at short. Forrest checking his corners, making sure all three of those terrorists are inside of the site, though. Freiburg going for the pick, does go down immediately to a nice shot by Schneider. One versus three retake, and he will immediately go down to Pronax. Good job by Fnatic to hold off the P250 armor by. Now Ninjas in Pyjamas will have to full save here. Try to set up in sneaky positions. We've noticed Ninjas in Pyjamas on save rounds try to go for long range pistoling shots to try to get those headshots, whittle the opponents down instead of just trying to outright surprise them. Which would seem to be the logical thing to do. Alright, and we have Fnatic playing it safe. Moving to take mid control. And they have it. They can go anywhere now. They smoked mid. That smoke mid means we're going short. We have Fnatic here to hold off the short. With Get Right as well. Terrace will be moving short. This has been the bane so far of Ninjas in Pyjamas play. Nade does do a little bit of damage to Fnatic, who's jumping up and down just to get vision of these players at short to make sure. Terrace now pulling back and will be taking bomb site B. They're going to do a mid to B, so poor Fnatic here will get smoked off. They do have plenty of smokes to deal with that. As the players just sort of walk into the side. Look at Forrest's position there on that box. Sneaky, sneaky. They actually are playing this sneakily. Oh, and Freiburg does take him down. Wow! Look at this. Counter terrorists are holding off this site. They just took down two players. Now Schneider runs in here. Forrest and Freiburg, who did hold that off brilliantly. Flaren jumps into the window there. Does go down, and now terrorists do have the site. That looked like it was going to be great there. Ooh, Flusha almost sees Exist, has his back to him. But a very, very fast flick shot. Goodness, that was the fastest flick shot I think I've ever seen there. Just boom, immediately on his face. And Fnatic will take that point. And good attempt there at a save round by the Ninjas in Pyjamas. Alright, Fnatic now starting to come back. They now are 1-2 against Ninjas in Pyjamas in points. We'll have to play a good comeback here. Fuflaren will be taking AWP here. This is the only map that Fuflaren plays AWP. Forrest will play AWP on every other map. Oh, and we have some engagements here at long. Not going to last, though. Baiting out some of their throws, some of their nades. And look at that. What is that? Double smoke mid. Maybe a little bit overkill there. Goodness. Preventing those players from seeing them as they try to go short A. So that's pretty much like a we are going short A. Fuflaren here is the player to hold off short A with this AWP. Other good place to... Where is he? Goodness. Was boosted up on top of that box, or jumped up there on top of that box. And Terrace getting ready to push A. There's a number of places you can play this from. One of the really strong ways to play AWP at bombsite A is to play at car, where Fuflaren seems to be gravitating towards. He's moving over to car. This is a very strong place to hold this off. Because he didn't get the initial pick, he fell back to watch it at car. But however, we do have the bomb, and it will be going at bombsite B. So Ninjas in Pyjamas over-rotating. They have all their players inside of A, and it will be a B take. Those two players there are just a distraction. And Freiburg is rotating! Oh, it did work! They completely tricked the Ninjas in Pyjamas. Terrace will be taking bombsite B. Mind games going on here, and Ninjas in Pyjamas has been tricked. They've been outstratted there. And here's Freiburg. Trying to get some headshots, trying to get some position to where those players are. And we get right over on the other side of the map. We'll be saving. Grab that AWP for Fuflaren. And Freiburg. Falling back as well. So they will be doing a save here. Get right, maybe able to get some exit frags here on those players as they leave the site. This is an interesting position to play from. And we'll all be going into CT spawn. Or T spawn. So there will be no fragging. And Fnatic will triumphantly leave and win it. They are definitely coming back. Ninjas in Pyjamas have not been able to take a single point on this half, and they are starting to dwindle here. This is a round where they're a little bit money hurt, but they will be blind, so they got Fomuses on the field. Flaren has his AWP, though, because they were able to save that thing. By saving those weapons, they were able to pull out another round here where they do have a buy. So Flaren going for a fast pick. Will he get it? Pushing here at short. He did have the spawn for it. He got boosted for it. He stops a little bit, so now may be the time for him to pull back. And Schneider pushing at short. Oh, the Flaren moves away just before that player was in fragging distance. And we have a defensive smoke there, and Terrace will sort of give short away now. I thought he was going for a quick pick, but did not push forward. Alright. Terrorists waiting for that smoke to clear before they try to do anything. JW here with his AWP will be picking at short. He knows that. We do have Flaren here who did miss the shot, and Terrorists now will be able to push at short. Flaren falling back, try and play a defense here. They have that bomb set up to go at short. One player making some noise at B. Oh, and JW takes out Flaren, making it look easy, and now Terrace will be easily able to just waltz into the site. Only exist here to watch short. Short has definitely been Ninjas in Pyjamas trouble here so far. And exist trying to frag those players. And it looks like Terrace will once again have the site. Counter Terrace have to play retake here. Ninjas in Pyjamas has been giving the sites a lot to Fnatic. Then trying to play the retake, playing it very safe. And it looks like they may be able to do this retake here. Pronax hold it off. Now just going to be Devil Walk, and he is way out of position. They can defuse that bomb. Devil Walk trying to move in. And he will go down, and Ninjas in Pyjamas will take that thing and will defuse that bomb eventually. There he goes. Forest taking it. And that was a good round there from Ninjas in Pyjamas. Did not expect that. They gave bomb site A to Fnatic, played the retake, and it worked out. And that was the first round that they have taken on that half. 1 point there for Ninjas in Pyjamas. Fnatic has been killing it. However, Fnatic is starting to get low on the money. If they lose this round, they may have to save here. They have no blue shell effect. All right. And they're doing a split. Two players ran into B and going lower. They can hear these players. And they've smoked out mid to move forward. We do have Ninjas in Pyjamas stacking B-side pretty heavily. One player inside of B, two at middle. So short, once again, is the place to take. And here's Flaren to hold this thing off with this AWP. Flaren, unfortunately, has not been able to hold off short at all. It has just been... they have been able to take A every single time. They only have two players here to watch it. This setup by Ninjas in Pyjamas is so risky. It is like, yeah, if you go B, you lose. But it's just rock, paper, scissors here. And they don't seem to be rotating. And it looks like Fnatic is setting up to do an A split. They got a 2-3 split set up. Two players short, three players long with the bomb. And they're going to throw the smoke down, cross with the bomb, plant that thing. It is going to be up to Get Right and Fiflaren. And three players pushing out at long. And Get Right gets picked by JW. Goodness, how did that happen? Fiflaren lands his shot, but it is going to be, unfortunately, a leg. And then Fiflaren goes down. He had a P2000. What were you planning to do with the P2000? It was like a finishing gun. There were two players at short. And now, Ninjas in Pyjamas has to play retake again. They played so heavy at B, and now they are going to suffer for it. I don't know what the reasoning there was. Maybe a, hey, they went short every round. Maybe this time they're not going to. Wow, the shots by Fnatic have been spot on. Absolutely perfect. Look at that! I mean, we don't even see that! It's so fast. So now it's just Exist. 1 versus 4. He will be aggressing here and saving this AK-47. The aims on Fnatic have been impeccable. Exist able to take down JW. And then Schneider perfectly shoots him in the face. Goodness. Fnatic is just on here. This is, of course, the grand finals of Dreamhack Winter 2013. Biggest Counter-Strike tournament of all time. And Ninjas in Pyjamas will be saving here on this round. We have a very, very... look at this spawn. This spawn is, like, tailored for a B push. And it looks like they will be doing this B push. Could be going lower... not going to be trying to push it. Very quickly puts four players in the tunnels, three lower. See Ninjas in Pyjamas here. At long A, got all three of their players set up against the wall there. And now looks like Terrace are setting up for a B take. Probably just going to be able to waltz into this site here as JW is a player inside of the derp spot, and he Mario's him. Now they're trying to retank this thing. We have two pistoling players. Probably just go for exit frags at this point. Devilox moving in for the kill, though. And that's for Flaren exist. Another smoke off, preventing these poor counter terrorists from doing anything. They're just free kills there. Trying to grab players as they move onto the site. Devil Wong has 69 health. Oh, just took another shot there. And Ninjas in Pyjamas. There's no reason to save. And terrorists will be able to move out of that site. All of them going through to T spawn. Through B. And counter terrorists get into the site just in time to explode and flip over backwards for dramatic effect. Alright, Ninjas in Pyjamas now in some trouble. Fnatic coming back. Ninjas in Pyjamas still has the lead. 13 points to 9. But Fnatic, they've only won one round so far on this half. Fnatic has definitely got this thing down. They are landing all of their shots perfectly. And Ninjas in Pyjamas has been playing very risky strategies. Fnatic has been abusing that, and here comes Fnatic now getting ready to push at B. They do get smoked off, though. Now rotating. And Ninjas in Pyjamas setting up in this same setup. Very B-heavy, these players. They allow them to push through middle. I think it's finally working out for Ninjas in Pyjamas. They have these two players here. Add some mid. Sort of baits them into a, hey guys, try to take B site, and then Exist pops out and takes them down. So that's what that strategy was supposed to do. It finally worked out. Oh, Pronax turns around. Now we have Freiburg inside of the site. He's got to hold this off, and he does go down. Now will be a two-player retake here. Exist did his job. That was the strategy that Ninjas in Pyjamas tried to do that other round. It did not pay off. Oh, no! But Flaren, one versus one, and Devil Walk takes him down, and Fnatic will take another point there. So let's examine that strategy by the Ninjas in Pyjamas. And they do put one player here, one player here, one player inside of B. And they do have, this is the vantage point. So as these players push through mid, there is no mid to B smoke. There's no player CT. When they frag this player, they don't know about this player hiding here, which was Exist, and he's able to take frags. He actually took three frags. However, I mean, look at that. Fnatic tried to do a B take. It was a standard B split. Very simple strategy, very strong strategy. Ninjas in Pyjamas had a strategy specifically tailored to deal with that strategy. Wow. How the heck did Flusha get that shot? And then Exist takes him down with a deagle. One deagle to the face through the whole thing there. And we just have pistoling counter terrorists. Devonk holds out B. This is the top play of Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Devil Walk doesn't even have to see the player, just shoots him through the corner there. Didn't have vision on Freiburg. And now Terrace will be taking bomb site B, will be planting that bomb. And once again, we have two players haplessly moving around the map. Oh, we got Fafleren setting up for a frag here on the exit frags if those players try to go. He's moving around a lot, he's making a lot of noise. And jumping will kill his accuracy here. I'm not sure what that was all about. And he will go down. He had a huge opportunity there to grab some exit frags. It was not able to do. It was jumping and moving around and stuff. Oh, Exist trying to get the one dig and does go down. And Fnatic takes another point. They are definitely coming back. Trying to grab a point here, even though it looked like Ninjas in Pyjamas had it in the bag. JW, going to be opping T-side. It's an aggressive. Flaren has an op, and Gidright has the auto sniper. And times that perfectly, but those players do get by. Schneider tries to take a pick at long. We have three players at long. Two of those should rotate back now. They are rotating back, and they will be watching short. So, Ninjas in Pyjamas is finally set up to be aggressive or be able to hold off short. They throw the defensive smoke, and the terrorists move back. They could allow these players to push at these positions if they have a strong hold off. Instead, they are smoking them out every time. Terrace now changed up their strategy. It looked like they were trying to do an A take. Now have decided they're going to be doing a B take. No! Smoking middle, and they're doing this strategy again. Fnatic puts two players at short, makes some noise, and then the players move into bomb site B and plant the bomb. They didn't even have to do their strategy that time because they grabbed the pick there. And now Ninjas in Pyjamas is in some trouble. They may be trying to save these guns already. Yeah, 3 versus 5. So let's examine that strategy once again by Fnatic. They've used it a few times. They didn't have to use it, but they have two players here at short, three players in B. They don't even worry about middle. These two players play short like they're going to be taking A. Ninjas in Pyjamas sees the two players, so they're probably going to rotate at least one player over in position to say, oh, they're probably taking A. And then they take these three players and just smash into B. It didn't work out that way, though, because the players inside of B got a pick. There was only one player left in here. And they're able to just move in, plant the bomb, and win that round. As we have the fortress of Ninjas in Pyjamas here, preventing these players from grabbing the exit frags. And that will be that. Fnatic takes another point. Fnatic has just been out-strategizing Ninjas in Pyjamas. Wow.
Yes. Yes.
Everything that Ninjas in Pyjamas tries, Fnatic's strategies have just been working. Alright. They still have this AWP here, T-side. Trying to time it perfectly. But they move very quickly. Look at this. Pronax running out here past blue. Charging forward. Schneider grabs a frag off of Gidright. And now they do have position here at short. Exist, though, is in position to hold it off. Wow. 2 versus 2 here at long. Bomb is dropped inside of T-Spawn. Fnatic just going for picks. How did Flusha get that shot? And that will be that. 3 versus 4 now. Counter Terrorist in a bad position. If you flare, and the only player at A knows that there's a player inside of pit. Terrorist now moving back to grab that bomb. They've still got a minute left in this thing. They can go anywhere. And they have set themselves up for a win. Flaren saying, hey, boost me short. Oh, okay, fine. Actually, he was just trying to check and see if those players were there. Still a player inside a pit. This is not how you should deal with a player inside a pit. Oh, Forrest almost goes down. And Freeburg takes out Devil Walk. They still have that player inside a pit. This is Flusha. He knows Forrest is here. Oh, he walks past, and Forrest grabs him, takes him down. Now going to be a 1 versus 2 here. Forrest with 15 health, and they know it. They know that Forrest is low. Oh, JW almost got that frag. Good flash. Forrest is going to be going for it, but Schneider takes him down. Now tying it up here, 13-13. Fnatic has just put themselves in a position to win this game. Goodness. Ninjas in Pyjamas is in some serious trouble. They just spent all their money on this round, and if they lose it, that puts Fnatic at 14 points against the saving Ninjas in Pyjamas. It is starting to look bleak here. Ninjas in Pyjamas really has to win this round. Alright, we have Fnatic now. Two players at B, going for the headshot. Freeburg just a little bit to the right there. Look at this setup here. By these two counter-terrorists. Absolutely lovely. Two players, one over the top, one on the bottom. So when those players moved out, they'd have to deal with two different weapons. Scary. Definitely a scary setup. They actually did not put the defensive smokes at B. Fnatic could have pushed in there. Would have ran into that setup. Instead, now they will be going at short A. We have no defensive smokes. Ninjas in Pyjamas doesn't have them. That's why. And Terra is still in middle. Haven't decided where to go yet. Here's Fflaren, who's been the A player. He's been watching short this entire game. Also has Exist. Alright, Terrace will be pushing here at short A. This is going to be just a classic A take here. Classic short A push. Let's get a good top-down vision of it. They throw the smoke inside of the site to take out all of those headshot vantage points. But Fflaren pulls back. Will be able to take one player down. Terrace now moving into the site. They have good position. They are getting picked off one at a time now. Ninjas in Pyjamas rotating to deal with this. They finally take out the two counter Terrace, and now we'll have to do a 2 versus 3 retake here. And Forrest and Freeburg. Trying to take out JW there. Forrest in a good position. Two Terrace go back too long. Ninjas in Pyjamas does not have a smoke to do the defuse. Oh, it is going to be safe planted, though. If they're able to take this site, they have a chance. But here is Pronax. Freeburg got a 1 versus 3. Oh, trying to take out the pistol. Pronax got a 4-frag. Let's get an owl vision. It is looking bleak for the ninjas in pyjamas. They have at this round bought, again, trying to win this thing, not trying to tie it. We have 4 FAMAS and a MAG 7. Fnatic, this close to victory. Can ninjas in pyjamas hold them off? And there's the defensive smoke, preventing them from taking B. Schneider rotating as well. They seem to only go for picks at B. They don't actually ever push in there. Just trying to get some headshots. Forrest in a good hold-off position. Just a sneaky around the corner. Going for the headshot at Xbox and up here at short A. Fnatic has not moved into a range of him. Smoke him out. Now we'll be able to move short. And flashes both of those players. We have 2 players holding off at short. Schneider now pushing forward. Will be going down to exist. And Terrace in some trouble now. Counter Terrace pushing forward at middle. Now just going to be Fusha left. 1 versus 3. Has that bomb. Plenty of time. 48 seconds left. But he's got to deal with 3 buying players. We have an AK-47 now on Freiburg. Able to steal that thing. We'll be moving into bomb side A. We'll be for Flaren to hold off short A once again. Fnatic has been abusing this spot though. Oh, almost hitting Flaren. Very good reflexes. Fusha. 26 seconds left. Still going for it here. And now counter-terrorists have started to rotate. Movement on him like Varlasa Raptors in the tall grass as he pushes forward to take this site. 15 seconds left. They give it to him. We'll be allowing him to plant this bomb. Flaren does take him down there. That was scary. Almost able to plant that thing. And that will be the round now. Putting it at 14-14. Ninjas in pyjamas staying in this game. Just 2 rounds left in this game. And it is all tied up now. 14-14 set up here for the end of game number 1. Roger. And we have an op on JW to watch middle. He's been timing these things just a little bit late. Now goes a little bit early. Look at this. Bunch of terrorists inside of B. Making it sound like they're doing a B push there. Instead, going to be going lower to watch short. Make sure there's no players pushed up. We have 3 players on ninjas in pyjamas at long. 2 should rotate back, and they do. If he flaring to watch short. It looks like they're going to be pushing through mid, so it is all up to Forrest. And he grabs Pronax. And he grabs Schneider. Then Fusha takes him down. Looks like counter-terrorists. They only have 1 player left to hold off B. That is going to be Freiburg. It looked like it was trying to be doing a mid to B there, and then gave up and will just be pushing into B. Freiburg should call the rotate. Counter-terrorist will be rotating. Oh no, he goes down. Here is Git right now, watching the cross. Cross has been smoked down. That allows JW to get onto plat. Flaren trying to pick him from the window. Terrace still not able to plant that bomb. Where the heck is Exist? Way over here, trying to come in from behind them. And they have not planted that bomb yet. 3 versus 3. This is such a tense round. Still have Exist creeping in there from behind him. Flaren grabs a frag and takes out JW. Now looks like Exist is getting ready to move in from behind. And we'll be planting that bomb. Now is the time to push. Ninjas in pyjamas does not push though. Here comes Exist from the back. And Fusha grabs both of those frags and Devilwalk takes the last one. Wow, Fnatic able to hold that thing off with Devilwalk with 1 health left, grabs that frag. Fnatic puts themselves at 15 points, 1 point away from a point from the first game win in the grand finals of Dreamhack Winter 2013. Excellent hold off. Ninjas in pyjamas looked like they had that thing. They had 3 players set up, 1 door, 1 window, 1 at B tunnels, getting ready to take the site perfectly set up, and they just got destroyed. Aggressively, Fusha pushes through the double doors and grabs both of those counter-terrorists. That was crazy. Alright, this is a scary round here for ninjas in pyjamas. We have a Deagle on Exist. We have 5 Zevens on Freiburg and Flaren. Mag 7 on Gidright and Ifamas on Forest. I love how it just worked out, like alliteration there. It was perfect. Alright, Terrace all middle. They can go anywhere. This is an easy round for them. Last round, it is match point here. This is the last round of the game. They have to take it. We have a stack by Ninjas in Pyjamas inside of bombsite A. Looks like they're getting ready to push at short. No, they're pulling back. JW. Oh, yeah, look at this. Terrace now getting ready to push at short. Gonna have to be a surprise hold off here. They're not gonna spring their trap. Oh, vision there. Exist does get vision of them as they push into this site. And Faflaren still hiding there. Exist now hiding. Waiting for these players to cross. See that blue line? It's gonna be Pronax, and Faflaren does take him down. Terrace pushing into the site. Oh, goodness, we have Freiburg and Gidright here to try and retake. 2 versus 3. Gidright is now low on health. And good flashes. Just Freiburg left. 1 versus 3. Oh, 1 versus 2, and he does go down, and Fnatic will take that thing. 16 points to 14. Congratulations to them, and moving on to game number 2, and they will start the thing 1 point up here in this best of 3 series, and Ninjas in Pyjamas has to play a comeback. Thank you folks very much for watching. I am the WarOwl, and I still have no closer.